the industry mentoring program. As always, we are very fortunate to have another wonderful person as our speaker today. Mr. Yasiru Nilan is a senior software engineer at Orange HRM. Of course, Yasiru has had industry experience ever since he graduated. He has worked at Orange HRM, climbed up the ladder. So, and I am fortunate to introduce another brilliant product of us. Yasiru graduated from Department of Computer Science and Engineering, University of Mauritius. I was very fortunate to see the young Yasiru who came to the department becoming a wonderful, mature professional. I'm sure Yasiru would talk about his the professional journey, but I think one thing we all at the Department of Computer Science and Engineering remembers about Yasiru is not only that he was a brilliant student, he was a very active student in multiple different activities. A wonderful and dynamic field representative. Yasiru was there to give leadership to his batchmates in any of the extracurricular activities we did. He was a member of multiple societies while at the university, from the technical societies such as ACM student chapter, the Microsoft, being a volunteer for Microsoft, all that. But he also had a tremendous interest of making the society a better place. The Leo Club was one of his involvements from the beginning, and today, I think today, Yasiru serves as a member of the Leo Club, the Leo District 362, the Sri Lankan one. So despite all those busy schedules, I think the brighter side of COVID is, Yasiru, we get to do these things online, so that catching you all amidst your busy schedules is no problem. So thank you so much, Yasiru, for agreeing to our very short request on you to do this. Because one of the things I recollect in the last semester was kids who were doing mobile application development found it like hard sometimes to do their assignments and all that. So we felt this may be a wonderful opportunity to talk to them about it. And I'm sure you would talk about the growing industry need for these kind of professionals. Thanks a lot, Yasiru. It's a really a memorable day for me to see one of my young graduates coming back to address the students. So thank you so much. And I'm sure you would one day do what Yasiru is doing today, coming back and addressing your juniors. Thanks a lot, Yasiru. And students, as always, you don't get these opportunities very often. So make sure that you ask questions and you get your doubts clarified. That is important. And like always, thank you so much, Ms. Sumudu, for organizing this and taking time to coordinate with resource people and do that. Have a wonderful session, everyone. Over to you, Yasiru.
Okay. Thank you, madam. Let me share my screen. Can you see my screen?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Vishak, madam, for that wonderful introduction about myself. Listening to that, it brought me some flashbacks from our time at university, and it made me a bit proud about myself as well. Thank you again, Vishaka madam. So I will get into the session since we have a limited time, like 1 hour. In this session, I'm going to talk about the how to get started with mobile application development. In this session, I'm not planning to do any hands-on session because of the time restriction. So we will first go through what mobile application development and how to get started, how to build up your path regarding mobile application development. And also apart, Vishakha madam already introduced me myself. I am Yasiru Nilan. I'm currently working as a senior software engineer at Orange HRM. And as madam mentioned also, I'm a proud product of Department of Computer Science and Engineering, University of Moratuwa. Okay. I would like if you guys can speak up during the session and ask any questions then and there, so I can answer them. And as well as when I'm asking questions, if you can answer them, and like even by unmuting yourself or by putting the answer in the chat, I prefer if you be interact during this session. Okay, so what is mobile application development? The word itself, the word itself gives the meaning. So we know that every day, every person is using mobile application. It might be tablets, smartphones, smartwatches, likewise. We know that only the infants are not using smart devices. Everyone from age like 5 to 70, 80, they all are using smart devices. Nowadays, it's like, it has been the trend. So we know that when we are using desktops, we are building different applications. When it comes to Windows, we have Office and some other softwares. Likewise, when we are using mobile applications, we need mobile applications for them as well. So the mobile application development itself means the development of applications to run in smart devices like smartphones, tablets, smartwatches, likewise. So why we focus on mobile application development? We know that the world has gone mobile. Nowadays, there's no restriction for us to access any application, because in the earlier days, it might have been a problem when you are getting when you are getting a call from the office to perform some task or do any activity. Nowadays, it's not a problem. Even if you are in a bus, even if you are in a car, even if you are in a shop, you can just use your mobile application and perform any task. So that's why we call the world has gone mobile. And also, if you take out some of the mobile application, some of the world class products like Microsoft Office and the email applications that we use, Gmail, like Gmail, Outlook, and all those applications, they need to stand out from the competition. They need to be in the top. So when everyone is using mobile application, why don't they cater the mobiles? So they have developed mobile application for them as well. And as well, as I mentioned earlier, accessibility is no more a problem. Where you are, whenever you are, you can access the mobile application and perform whatever the tasks that you are intended to do. When you're talking about mobile applications, we have identified different phases. Let's say those are generations. In the earlier days, when these mobile applications first appear, we identified them as the first generation, because during that time period, limited number of mobile applications were developed, and it was hard to develop mobile application. And let's say we know that there are two main mobile systems. One is iOS, which is produced by Apple, and the Android devices. So when we need to download some application, let's say Gmail, every day we use that one. When we need to download Gmail, we need to download it for Android using Play Store. And if you are an iOS user, you need to download it from App Store. So when we need to develop a mobile application for those two platforms, we need to create two mobile applications. Even though it does the same thing, we need to create two separate mobile applications. That's why we call it's hard. Even though it's the same functionality, at least two developers need to work on that, because to develop the mobile application to iOS, you need to know Objective-C language or either Swift. Swift language came recently. Objective-C is the older one. So if you need an iOS application, you should know Objective-C or either Swift. And if you need the same application in Android, you need to know Java. Nowadays, there's another language, just Kotlin as well. So that gives you the difficulty, because for the same application you need to know two different, at least two different languages. So that was a hassle. And when it comes to Windows applications, you need to know .NET framework and C#. So it was a hassle. One developer can't do all those things. So due to that, the industry was asking for more. And then it came the second generation. We call it as hybrid HTML and JavaScript frameworks. We call this hybrid because, as I told you earlier, in the first generation, we need to develop the same mobile application in three different languages. That means, like, as an example, three developers, three coders need to work on that. There were three separate projects. So when it comes to second generation, it was one code base. You need not multiple developers. If you know JavaScript and HTML, you can create both iOS and Android mobile applications. I'm not in the earlier days when I started my career as well, this second generation was there. People were using it frequently. So whenever we needed to do a mobile application, we were using this hybrid mobile applications, and the tools that were there to support were PhoneGap and Cordova, as well as Ionic. So these were the tools that the developers at that time used to develop mobile applications. So using the second generation, we identified we need not multiple code bases, multiple projects, multiple developers. One developer can develop the web mobile application, and we can create the iOS app, Microsoft app, and Android app separately from the same code base. So compared to the first generation, second generation was hassle-free, but there were some problems as well. When it comes to second generation, the look and feel and how the app behaves was somewhat problematic. The look and feel didn't look nice. So the performance-wise also, it was not meeting the industry standard. So again, developers were asking more. Then it comes the third generation. So now we are in the third generation. So whenever we are developing mobile application, we are using this cross-platform mobile application development. Cross-platform means it's somewhat similar to second generation as well. In cross-platform, similar to second generation, we are using a single code base. And we develop the mobile application, we code it, and at the end, we are creating the Apple app, the Android app, and the Windows app. So we can create multiple apps from the same code base. So one developer can focus on the application development, and at the end only, he will be creating the iOS app from the same code base as well as the Android app. So it was something easy for the developers, and the output of that one, like the native UI UX, the appearance, look and feel, that was quite similar to the native applications that we developed, and also the performance wise and development time that we spent was reduced, and performance increased, and how the time taken to get started also reduced. So most of the developers tend to start developing their mobile application using third generation cross-platform frameworks and libraries. So in the third generation, we have identified multiple frameworks and tools that support cross-platform application development. One is React Native. React Native is a cross-platform mobile application development framework, and Xamarin, that's also there, and Native Script is there, as well as, even though I have not mentioned here, we have Flutter, which also came recently. So in the next slide, I will be explaining about each and every third generation frameworks. So React Native, why? I explained you the problem that the developers earlier they had, because if they wanted to develop a mobile application, they needed to have multiple code bases with different languages, and React Native solved this problem because one code base for multiple mobile apps, and React Native is based on JavaScript. And the easiest part is most of the web developers are familiar with JavaScript, so getting started with React Native was easier for them because they were already familiar with JavaScript. So that's somewhat they can start it quickly. And most importantly, this was backed by Facebook. As you all know, we are using this Facebook's applications, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Instagram, WhatsApp. All those applications are powered by Facebook, and React Native also backed by Facebook. So that's a strong entity. So when they started something, people start to follow them as well. So nowadays, most of developers are using React Native for mobile application development for that kind of reasons. And as you can see, I have listed down few of the mobile applications that were developed using React Native. Facebook itself developed its all mobile application using React Native. Instagram is also part of them. And the Airbnb, the popular renting and sale application, and Skype, which is a product of Microsoft, and Walmart, the online shopping app. And especially React Native is adopted by Microsoft as well, because for most of the Microsoft new mobile applications, they are using React Native. So we can see a huge potential regarding the React Native when it comes to mobile application development. So the next one, Flutter. This is also a new framework that came recently. When it comes to mobile applications using cross-platform, Flutter plays a major role as well as React Native. But the problem here is this Flutter framework is based on Dart. It's a language which is also introduced by Google as well as the Flutter. So when it comes to developing applications using Flutter, you need to have another requirement. You need to know Dart. So even though Flutter is easy compared to React Native, learning Dart is there. So if you're familiar with Dart, getting started with Flutter, that's really easy. And compared to React Native, that's really fast. But if you don't know Dart, then you have to know, you have to learn Dart language as well. So depending on the developer, that adds overhead of development. And since it is new and recently introduced, the developer community is also growing day by day. So whenever you run into issues, you can find solutions online, because most people have used Flutter, and they also might have get the issue that you face when you are developing the mobile application. As I mentioned, Flutter is backed by Google, and they used Flutter for most of their mobile applications. I have listed down a few which I could find. Google Ads mobile application that is developed using Flutter, and the Alibaba, the trading platform mobile application, that's also developed using Flutter, and as well as BMW's self-care application that is also developed using Flutter. So you see that even in React Native and Flutter, there are a lot of leading companies who are using these cross-platform mobile applications. Then the third one is Xamarin. People may pronounce this differently, but this is also a major framework that is used for cross-platform mobile application development. The differences between React Native and Flutter is, in Xamarin, you need to know C# or .NET. If you know .NET, getting started with Xamarin is really fast. And this is backed by Microsoft. We know that React Native is backed by Facebook, Flutter is backed by Google, and Xamarin is backed by Microsoft. These three giants in the tech industry are backing these three frameworks. And they have these frameworks are having a huge potential. Because of that, those companies are backing these projects. And this is also not a new one, but it came out a couple of years back, developed by a company separately. Then later Microsoft acquired them. So this is also a trending mobile application development framework, which is used for cross-platform application development. So if you are using the Microsoft News application, you are using an Xamarin used mobile application, and as well as the UPS, the famous courier. Their application is their mobile application is also developed using Xamarin framework. So those are the three major frameworks that are available today to start with mobile application development. So why I am focusing these three only is because if you need to develop a mobile application, as I said, you need to create the application as fast as you can. Because if you are taking so much time developing your mobile application, your competitor may release a product faster than you. So you will not be able to reach the market. So cross-platform application development is the trend nowadays, because you can get the app up and running so fast. So if you are interested in getting with mobile application development, these are the few steps that you need to follow. Depending on your language proficiency, you may know JavaScript, you may know Dart, you may know .NET and C#. And depending on that, you can start a sample project and develop some features on it, like a to-do application, weather application. Likewise, there are sample projects that you can get started. And when you're developing that one, you'll get to know a lot of things. Because during a presentation, myself or no one can give you all the things. What we can give is the glimpse. But when you create a sample application and you start developing the mobile application, you will know the problems that that you face and the solutions, as well as the norms and practices that are used. So getting started with a simple project, it need not to be a complex one. It can be a simple one. Getting started with the sample project is the best way to start learning. And as well as when you're developing the mobile application, search about the best practices, because you are not the first person who will be developing a mobile application. So if you are not having much experience about that, you may make some mistakes, not deliberately, but sometimes you may make some mistake. So to avoid those things, the best thing is to follow coding practices. To get to know them, you need to do some research about them and how the mobile application should look like. They are also available as resources in the internet, because people like the nice of the mobile application, the nice things, the look and feel, the UI UX. Those are the things people consider when it comes to mobile application. Even the functionalities are working. Let's say it's a weather application. Even it shows the weather data correctly. If the app is not looking good, or the look and feel is not that good, people will not use that application, because people think about look and feel most of the time when it comes to mobile applications. And while you are developing the mobile application, talk to others, get others' feedback, because when it comes to development, not only mobile application, when it comes to software development, getting others' feedback is really important. Because when you do that, when you talk to others, you get a lot of things. They might give you some feedback, and you can use that and create some amazing applications with your work. Okay. So I talk about how to get started with mobile application development, and as a mobile application developer, I will explain to you my journey. I joined Orange HRM as a associate software engineer, and after a couple of years, now I am as a, I'm working as a senior software engineer, and I am currently working at the mobile application team, and working as a mobile application developer. So when I first joined at Orange HRM, there was nothing like a mobile application, and those days going mobile was not a priority. So later only, when the trend started, we decided that we also need a mobile application. Not only us, I'm taking our company as an example, not only us, most of the companies, couple of years back, they might not have a mobile application requirement, but when it comes to these days, there's a huge necessity for mobile application, especially with this COVID situation, people are working remotely. So to do most of the actions in the organization, they need mobile applications, even for like attendance tracking and the work tracking. Likewise, they are using mobile applications. So nowadays, the mobile application development is a trend, and most of the companies are giving mobile applications for their apps. And when it comes to mobile applications, cross-platform is the norm nowadays. So no more people are developing Android apps separately and iOS apps separately. But if they have time and resources, they go to developing native applications. But with the limited resources and limited time, people are mostly doing cross-platform mobile application developer. And nowadays, there's a role, especially as mobile developer. Earlier days, it might not be the case, but nowadays, there's a special role, mobile application developer. So when it comes to hiring as well, knowing this mobile application development adds a huge potential to you to get selected to the through the interview for that position. So learning and practicing mobile application development is a must if you are willing to improve your knowledge, and if you are willing to get some bonus points in your next interview when it comes to going to the industry. So before going to Q&A session, I will show you something. Hope you all can see my browser. Can someone respond?
Yeah.
Okay. This is a sample application that I developed for similar kind of training that I did. And this developing this sample application is taking some time. That's why I created it beforehand. I'm showing it to you to show you how easy to get started with mobile application development. So this is an online application, and this gives the COVID-19 statistics of Sri Lanka. So as you can see in here, I have only a couple of files in here for this mobile app, and it's developed using JavaScript. If you can go see this one, and in the real time, this is giving me the output of the application. So if you can see, and if I switch to Android and run on your device, if you can see my screen, you also can scan this QR code and see the application on your mobile phone itself. I'll make it a big bit larger. If you can scan this QR code, you can also see. So since it will take time, I will show it in my device. If I go to this Android tab and, sorry, have to play. since it's an online hosted one, it will take some time to load the application. So the thing that I wanted to show you from here is how easy and how quickly you can get started with the application development. Because if you have the background in JavaScript, .NET, or any other language, getting started is really quick. And also, if I go to the resources, if I go to React Native's document, it shows who are using mobile applications for React Native, using React Native. You can see the Facebook related applications, then Instagram, the QS, the VR app, the Shopify, the online marketplace. Most of the applications that you may be using, Skype, Bloomberg, Pinterest, Uber Eats, nowadays most people are using. And yeah, you may know most of these applications and you might not know that were, that they were developed using React Native. So you can see how the world leaders are using these frameworks to develop their mobile application. So if I go to the Flutter documentation, they are showing their top clients as well, who have developed mobile applications using Flutter. And BMW, the self-care application, and this NU Bank, Google Assistant, some of the applications. Likewise, they are also having a large number of clients who are using React Native, Flutter for their mobile application. When it comes to Xamarin, as you can see, the postage, the Academy of Motion Pictures, Arts and Science, who are presenting the Academy Awards, they are using it for one of their mobile applications. The UPS, the courier service, Alaska Airlines, likewise. There are a lot of clients, there are a lot of world-leading companies who are using cross-platform mobile application development, because nowadays that is the norm for mobile application development. If we go here, this will take some time. Let's wait to see. Seems it is taking time, like we move on. What I was expecting is this will show the mobile application, the look and feel, and the, how it behaves in the mobile app. But we can view the web view of that same application. And using this one, you can create the final iOS app and Android app separately and upload it to Play Store and App Store separately. So you can distribute it among the people who will be using. So you can see a simple application, and if you go inside some of these, the number of PCR cases that were done each and every day, and yeah, and I'm not sure how to go back from here. Yeah, likewise. So there are a lot of resources. If you are going to start with mobile application development, there are a lot of resources. So Expo, the specific one that I'm using here, Expo is a good place for you to start mobile application development. If you are new, if you don't know anything about mobile application development, Expo is a good place to start your mobile application development, because it's the React Native itself proposes to go with Expo if you are new. So the most of the tedious tasks that developer has to do, all those are automated. So the things that you have to perform to get started is minimum. So within no time, you can get started your application and get it up and running. So I will share this link as well with you at the end of the session. So you can go through these tutorials and get started, because mobile application development itself is a major role in the industry nowadays. When it comes to software industry in Sri Lanka as well, the companies are separately hiring mobile application developers. So when you are going to interview after all this, you'll be getting the bonus marks, because you have followed some mobile application development part during your before your career start. So that's all from my side for the moment. And if you have any questions, we can I can answer them.
Could you please explain me developing mobile application using Angular?
Angular.
Yeah.
Okay. This the ones that I explained to you, the Flutter, React Native, and Xamarin, those do not support mobile application development using Angular, but the generation that I mentioned earlier, the second generation, the hybrid HTML and JavaScript frameworks, they do support Angular. When it comes to Ionic, I'll show you an example. If I go to Ionic, Ionic framework, which falls under the second generation, this itself supports Angular as the framework for mobile application development, and as it supports React as well, but this supports Angular as well. If you want to get started with Angular and mobile application development, you can go ahead with Ionic framework. The React, the Flutter, and Xamarin, those do not support Angular. I hope I answer your question.
Yeah, thanks.
Any others? If you have any questions, you can put it in the chat as well. There's a question. Yeah, there's a question Devinka has asked. Do you recommend learning Java, Kotlin, or moving straight to a framework? Here's the thing. These two are two separate things. When it comes to industry, it may be different from the company to company. Some of the things that we can achieve using JavaScript and Kotlin, like the native development, there are certain things that we cannot achieve using cross-platform application development. So if the client is specifically asking for some of the features like that, or the look and feel, going for Java Kotlin is the best option, and companies are doing that. And if you have limited resources, what companies are doing is use cross-platform application development. But learning Java and Kotlin, or the cross-platform development, that may be a preference of you. So if you know Java, Kotlin, you can develop native applications. But if you know cross-platform application development, that will be an added advantage, because you will know the iOS app development as well as React Native Android application development as well. So it's a preference, but there are some added advantages when it comes to learning cross-platform application development. There's another question. Mobile application development and creative website. Mobile application development and creative website and mobile application in a creative website, mobile responsive website. What are the difference? I'm not sure what is meant by creative website. I'm not familiar with the word. Mobile application development, it's like we are developing a mobile application which is installed in our mobile device. Okay, like when we need Facebook to use in our application, there are two things that we can do. We can either type facebook.com in the browser, phone browser, and go to Facebook. And another thing is we can have the Facebook mobile application. So then you need not to go to the browser, Chrome or someone, something, and interact with Facebook using that one. You can use the mobile application itself. So mobile application is itself a built-in one, which you can install separately in your mobile application, mobile for, device. And mobile responsive web apps mean those are websites, web applications. You can view it using browser, the desktop, laptop, or phone, anywhere. You can view it. And when it comes to viewing, we know that desktop or the laptops are, the screens are larger, right? The screen resolution is high. So we can view a larger part in the application. When it comes to mobile, viewing the same application, we see a small part only. So to make it possible to show the content in an interactive way, there's a way that we can develop web applications in a responsive manner. So that is, we called as mobile responsive web apps. So mobile responsive web app is not a mobile application that we cannot install in our mobile application, mobile device. That's a web application that we are viewing through Chrome or some other browser. That's another question. What is the difference between native platform and cross-platform? Okay. I thought I'd explain this part. Let's say cross-platform, when it comes to cross-platform application development, as I said, there's one code base, and we are creating the separate iOS app, Android app, and Windows app. So that is what we call as cross-platform application development, because we are using one single code base. And for that one, you need to know only a single language, because we are using the same code base. And if you talk about the native, between native development, that's the first generation, because for the Android application, you need to know Java and create a separate project and do the coding there with Java, Swift, Java, Kotlin. And in the same native generation, if you need to develop an iOS app, you need to know Swift or Objective-C and code it separately. So that's the difference. You need to know multiple languages, as well as there are two code bases that we need to maintain and create that. But when it comes to cross-platform, you are having one single code base and you are creating the app separately at the end. Hope that I answered that correctly. Yeah, that's all the questions in here. Are there any questions?
Yeah. So are we able to use Firebase as a database for React Native without any specific backend?
Without any specific
language, backend language.
I didn't hear the last part. Last part.
No. Are we able to use the Firebase as a Firebase as a database without any specific backend language like Java, anything?
Yeah, you are asking about cross-platform, right?
Yeah, I mean, asking about the database thing, accessing the data.
Yeah, and when when it comes to cross-platform application development, let's say you are developing a React Native mobile application. And there, if you want to access Firebase, you need not to know any other language. That's totally handled through JavaScript. So you need to install the Firebase, the connector package in the project. And all the things are handled through JavaScript. You need not to know any other language. But if you are developing a native application using Java, Kotlin, or something, since you are using Java, you need to code that connection part separately using Java. So for cross platforms, you need not to know any Java part if you are developing mobile application.
So the thing is, let's say when we're developing API in Spring Boot, so there's a security like to access each and every API, JW token and Spring Boot security, right? So what about the when we are using React Native and the Firebase as a database, is there any security like to access each and everything? So because of when we're using the Firebase as a database, so we need a security, right? So that's why I'm asking.
Yes, but since you are developing the mobile, the API, the backend part using Spring Boot Java, the connection to the database is handled through Java, right? The mobile application, but the mobile application is doing is calling the API provided by this Spring Boot application and get the data or send the data. Like us, the communication part is handled there. So the mobile application does not need to have knowledge about the Firebase connection, because that is handled by Spring Boot application, because we are not exposing any database to the mobile application. So in that case, there's no issue. There's no connection between the Java part and the Firebase with the front-end mobile application using React Native. What are the debugging tools used in mobile application development? Are there any special ones? Yeah. Even though I explained to you the three frameworks that are used in cross-platform application development, the Flutter, React Native, and Xamarin, I am familiar is the React Native one. So when it comes to React Native, there are a lot of debugging tools that are available free and which we can get connected easily. One thing is React DevTools, which we can use as a debugging tool, because it will give all the information related to the application, as well as we have Flipper, which is also a product of Facebook company, and all these tools are free and available to you for you to download and use it in your mobile application. And they are like, with my experience, they come really handy when you are developing the mobile application, because debugging is something that we don't like to do, right? When it comes to issues, we don't like to debug and fix the issues. So if we have to do debugging, there are a lot of tools available. I'm not sure about the Flipper and the Xamarin, but those also should have, because there's a huge community that is using. So the tools should be freely available for those as well. Yeah. In native web development, the file type is APK. What is about cross-platform? For example, let's say that is developed by React Native. Does the file type is both handled? Yeah. To answer this question, he's asking about the file type that is created at the end. So we know that if we develop a separate the native Android app, the format is like APK .apk, and when it comes to iOS, that's a separate file. And when we do use cross-platform, example as a React Native, at the end what we are getting is when we are like, even though we code it in the same project, we are creating the application separately. So if we want to create the iOS app, we run a separate command, then it will give you an output of the iOS app. When you want to create the Android app, you run a separate command, and that will give you an output of the Android file. That means when you create the Android build, it will give you a APK file. So it will be separately, even though we code it in a single code base. When it comes to build time, it will give you separate APK file for iOS and Android separately. Yeah. Are there any other questions? Okay. Okay, so if you have any questions, you can get in contact with me and email my email to my email address. I will share it at the end. And I hope you all get to know something that you didn't knew, and which you will be using for your future career. Because after a couple of, currently also you may be doing some job at the moment, and some of you might be not doing a job at the moment, but willing to do a job in the coming years. So mobile application development is a good place for you to start. So I think you at least you get something through this presentation, even though I had to I didn't do any hands-on session due to this limited time period. So